Hello and welcome back to Let's Play A Tear of Vermillion Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We just defeated Borgid down here. But before we go, I want to check this grave again. If I can find it. This is it, isn't it? I'm not sure. Oh! Up here. Oh, the flower's there. Can I... Okay. Avin says, this is Dominique's grave. Hey, Gawain. Can you bring me here again once we settle what we need to do? Next time I want to bring some flowers. Sure, no problem. Ruti says, we need two bouquets then. I think Madrim's spirit is resting here as well. Michelle says, our thoughts are contained in a bouquets of flowers. Maybe we're an existence that survives in between thoughts. I think that's what's referred to as a bond. Okay, you gotta lost me here. I agree, says Gawain. Shall we head back to the village? Huh. He's right. Our thoughts are handed down. Dominique's thoughts are handed down to Madrim, and Madrim's thoughts were handed down to us. Then I have no reason to mourn. Oh wow, see? I don't know if it would stop you from leaving the cemetery. Like if Avin would go, hey, I just want to check something. Check the grave. Because I just decided to go there. Sorry I made you wait. Let's head to Canafia. Go again. Forgetting how to get over there. Yeah. Nothing, right? Oops. Oh, okay. Alright, let's go. Getting stuck over here. I don't want to go back up there. I want to go down, but not... Oh, here we go. Ugh, God. Ah! Getting dizzy over here. I can't head straight down from there. Right. How do I get down? What the hell? Wait, wait, wait. Wait, wait, wait. Let me down. Let me down. Wait, wait. Okay. Up here. Why is it so hard to get down? That's why they did it for us. There's gotta be a way down, man. It just can't be that... So weird. How did I get over to the left? I know I was there. It doesn't let me go. It lets me go there. What the hell, man? Now I can't even get off this. I'm even worse than I was. Wait a second. Now we're down here. Can I head straight? No, I go up. Okay. I can't go down here, can I? Oh! Okay. Now, I've been down here before. Oh my god. Down! Get down! Is he stuck on a tree? Can't go down here either. Really? Thank you. I don't know if I can keep it though, because I can't advance in the game. More stuff I can't use. Thank you very much. Maybe between this stuff here? Nope. And maybe over here? Nope. It doesn't let me. Wait. Oh my god. Why was that so difficult? Let's get the hell out of here. Ugh. Okay, I hate this place now. Are we monster free right now? Like down in the shrine? I can't believe how hard it was to get down from there. I was supposed to turn around and start going south. Oh no, it's north. South to get there. I don't know what to come back. I get the feeling that Madrim will show himself this year. I'd like to drink with him if he comes. Go away and just give him that look. Mr. Gawain, are you going back already? Did you go visit the grave already? Yeah, I'll come again to visit their graves. Their graves? Oh, I see. I think they both will be happy. I hope so. It was good to see you. Please be careful on your way back. Well, I get to keep all the little gifts. We're full of SP Arcanum 1 again. There was someone down here, right? Oh, he's just... Yeah, it's the same stuff, right? It looks like the store downstairs is making good money. They say customers who come once in a while in a boat buy expensive things. Yeah, they sure do. He's not going to say anything new, or he's going to tell me to come from behind the counter. Same here, but I'll talk to her. I heard you guys are leaving already. Why don't you check out our goods before you leave? I already did. There's nothing useful. My nervousness just went away. I don't know why. Sage Gawain says, I see. Maybe it's because the graveyard fog lifted. Did your fog in your heart lift too, Mr. Gawain? Why do you think that way? Because your eyes tell me so. Am I wrong? No. That reminds me, the flower meaning of the white lily. I'm sure it was the innocent bride. It's although I can feel Sister Dominique's feelings for Brother Madrim. I'm going to go clean around Dominique's gravestone. I feel like doing it. That's nice of you. It looks like the fog lifted at the graveyard. The heaven is open. I'm sure Madram's thoughts will reach Dominique. You're heading back to the Holy Capital, right? Be careful on UC voyage home. You look tired. Hey, I should rest. Is that where we're going? Back to the Holy Capital? Oh, because we gotta destroy that barrier. I think that's everybody. Just make sure I didn't miss a shop or something. Did I talk to you? Did I talk to you? Yes. We're done. Let's get out of here. Thomas. Hey, dude. I've been waiting for you. We've finished repairing the planetos for a while now. Gawain says, yeah, a lot of things happened. Sir? Is something the matter? No, it's nothing. We got a lot done. Forget the sacred treasures. The sword we were talking about is finished. The sword we talked about? Avin says absolutely nothing. Avin showed Thomas a Lucian sword. Is that the sword that is used to cut through the Octum barrier? Yeah. This is the sacred sword Illusion. It contains the power of Bardas. Sometimes I spell it with the C-I-O-N and T-I-O-N. It seems to be like 50-50. Yeah, you did it, Avin. Now we can go help Mile and them. Then we know what to do next. The Planetos is ready to leave at any time. Depart. I was waiting for this. Go ahead, get on. I'll show you just how fast the Planetos can go. Okay. Don't kill us now. With the death of Madram, all sacred treasures were now in the hands of Avin. The sword originally created by man is indwelled by the Holy Spirit of Bardas and reforged to become the sacred sword Illusion. Back to the using the sea this time. It was a long, hard journey. Without the help of many people, the sword would have never been made complete. The weight of the sword was proof of the power of gods and of the hopes of the people. The Sage of Power, the wizard from another world, and the girl who has accompanied him in his journeys are by his side. All worries are now gone. Well, I wouldn't say that. Still worried about Mile and Amel. To save the lives of those he loves, Avin sets out towards Cathedral. I keep almost pressing the button. Probably would have skipped the cutscene. Oh wow, look at all these green-haired warriors. The blue-haired. Chapter 4, A Tear of Vermillion. Sounds familiar. Avin says, look how things are going now. The King's Army, the Paladin, volunteer soldiers from the Adventurer Guild. It looks like all the forces of Elfilden have gathered here. Priest Quar says, the huge attack of the Octum's Apostles started right after the earthquake the other day. All of Elfilden is in crisis because of the numerous numbers of the monsters they released. There was no time to lose. Rutis says, finally, the last battle will start. Gawain says, each troop of the King's Army, the Paladin, and the Guild are headed for the multiple enemy bases. That way we can keep their attention there. Avin says, and we are to destroy the barrier with the sacred sword when the opportunity permits and break into the cathedral, right? Don't you have to use more forces other than us? Michelle says, I don't think it's a good idea. It's because they can summon as many monsters as they want. If you move the big troops and they realize our plan, it's over. It's better to storm the cathedral with a few elite soldiers. Gawain says, Michelle's right. I want only the people here to storm into the cathedral. Avin, are you ready? Of course. I kept on going for this moment. I'll rescue Amel and Mile with my own hands. Then, Rutis, you won't be able to avoid a direct showdown against Lord Belius there. I'm still not sure if you should come with us. As for me, I don't want to see a master and disciple fight against each other. Rutis says, sure, I can't totally hate Lord Belius. He's the one who gave me direction when I was suffering. Avin says, Rutis, maybe you should stay here. But the ways are not just to be given. I think that now we have to find our own ways. During this journey with Avin, I found the way I should take. And the way is leading to the cathedral. Please, take me with you. Rutis, says Avin. Gawain says, I guess I took something too seriously. Mr. Michelle? To begin with, you are a foreigner, so I don't assume you have any pretext with the Octum's apostles. If someone distinguished like you could take our side, it would be so helpful, but you don't have any obligation to join us. Michelle says, like I said before, this war is not the only problem of Valkd. If by any chance Octum was to resurrect my hometown, Tirasweel won't be safe either. So please let me help. Thank you, says Gawain. Then, Sir Quar? The priest says, Lastly, there is something I have to tell you. It's about Eleusion. Avin says, what about the sacred sword? Do you remember the word in the scripture of Bardas? A shattered piece of Bardas will dwell within a sword that is harder than steel and lighter than a feather. And it will become a streak of light that will drive away great darkness. It will be called Sacred Sword Eleusion. Yeah, I kind of remember. There's more to the sentence. The one who obtains the sword will put an end to the long-lasting trifle between light and darkness with exquisite glitter. Glitter. And the people will see the season of leaving the nest come around. Avin says, the exquisite glitter? Season of leaving the nest? What do they mean? Quar says, this verse has been interpreted in various ways, but no one has found a clear answer. But I can say this for sure. The one who holds this sacred sword will control the fate of the world. I just want to let you know that. Avin says, control the fate of the world, huh? But it'll be me, no matter what. I don't think whether or not I hold the sword of Bardas will change my actions, though. Quar says, I think you are on the right track. Go to the cathedral, bring back important things, and create a new future. Yeah, I gotta go, says Avin. May the light shine your way. Okay. Alright, so now we have to go around and check with everyone again. There were many oracles until only a short while ago, but suddenly everybody's gone. What on earth is going on? They're carrying on about the monster problem, and I feel like something bigger is happening. You feel correct. I'm tired of prayers and magic. I want to go home. But I don't want to trouble my mom, so I won't say anything selfish. Did you see what was going on in the front yard? This is my first time to see so many soldiers all at once. They are not there to just get rid of the monsters, I guess. How do you know? Oh. Got something, Kitty? Nope. Oracle Purdy? After finding out about you, Instructor has changed his way of thinking. He said, it's not the time to pray, but the time to save the people. That's why the oracles who are doing ascetic practices of silence here have gone to places in Elfilden. We won't make only you carry all the burden. We will fight the way we can. Okay. Oracle Davis. Immediately after I renounced the world, serious matters have happened. This may be the fortune of the destiny. What's the fortune of the destiny? I'm not discontented with staying guard, though. This is finally the last battle. I believe in your victory. May Bardas protect all of you. Is this guy still down here? Avarice? I heard that man died. Haha, now I can sleep in peace at night. Bardas must have punished him. Avin says, bastard. Gawain says, it's his problem. Leave him alone. Already opened all those chests. Nothing else in here to see. Oh, Sunday school. We received a letter from the Benequia Monastery. It said that they started their relief work of the town and villages which had been damaged by the monsters. Really? Says Avin. Good to hear they're doing well. Just taking care of the convent is hard, but Miss Olesia handled with no problem. Yes, she says, but things are getting more serious. I wonder if the day will ever come when we can teach children about this disaster as a part of history. Don't worry, says Avin. The day will come soon when we can laugh and talk about these incidents. Many oracles have left for relief work to the area that received serious damage. I decided to pray here for everyone's safety and for restoration of peace. No, you're just a coward. Just a minute. Don't do anything more than you're capable of. No matter how hard you try, you would not be able to do it. Think how you can use your ability effectively, or your ability will be increased. Pride and self-esteem will become a double-edged sword. Humility and discretion will become a shield that beats a sword. May Bardas shine your shield. A shield that beats a sword. Talk to all these people. Nobody in there. Empty rooms. Oh, Dr. Bandle. Hello, Avin. We saw each other again. And now we see each other again. Dr. Bandle, what are you doing here? Sir Callian, who is in charge of medical, is going to accompany the paladin. Therefore, I asked if I could work as a substitute for him. So I took a break from traveling. Thank you for your work, says Ratis. Well, Dr. Bandle, may I ask you something? Sure, if it's something I can answer. What is the reason why you continue your journey? Oh, have I never told you? It's my father's will. He said, make the flowers of Panacare bloom. Panacare is an important elixir in legend, right? Michelle asked. You know well. I looked all over Elfilden, but I could not find it anywhere after all. But I won't give up. I'll fulfill my father's will without fail. Gawain says, your father told you to make the flower of Panacare bloom, not to look for it, right? Yes. Then you have already fulfilled his will. Legendary Panacare is said to bloom in the people's hearts and dreams. For those who are helped by you, you're nothing but a Panacare flower. I never thought of it that way. Haha, I've met the late Dr. Bandle several times. I'm sure he is very proud of you now. A flower of Panacare blooms in the people's hearts. He was a pretty witty person, wasn't he? I'll continue my journey and help those who are suffering from illness and injuries. It's because I believe that's the way I'm supposed to follow. Ruti says I wonder if I could also find my own way. Swing. Kid here now. I remember the last time I saw him catch a reed leaf. Ah, Avin, how are you? This grand cathedral is pretty deserted because oracles are gone to various places. I'm somehow sad. Why do the people fight each other? On the other hand, they could produce beautiful things like stained glass windows in the chapel. Yeah. Truly, says Avin. My dream is to become a craftsman. I want to create something that can move people like stained glass windows in a chapel. I believe that if the people's minds are softened and enriched, the fighting won't occur. I see, says Avin. Good luck on making your dream come true. I'll cheer you too. I'll cheer you too. Sounds like a threat. Ha. You are finally storming to the cathedral. We're going to protect this town of Valkd, where you are to return. Good luck. May Bardas protect you. Here's the other smaller resource room. Due to the emergency of Elfilden, I came to the Holy Capital. I, Duke Arryn, won't spare any cooperation as an heir. That is just an ostensible reason, though. As a matter of fact, I'm a big fan of Swordswoman Saffy by Karamuro Karamas. I came here because I wanted to meet Sapphire Eyes. I asked the guild about her, then they told me she has gone to the Eastern Continent for some kind of mission. I can't believe that we got our wires crossed. I think that's it. Please be careful. May Bardas protect you and bestow you with victory. This is going to be the last battle. Just leave the guard of the Grand Cathedral to us. If and in I have to. The voice of a girl yells, Avin, please wait. That voice, says Avin. Oh, Shannon, Avin says. Sir Quar has told me everything. Myland is in the hands of bad people, isn't he? Avin says, it's a little different than that, though. Don't worry about Myle. I promise you that I will rescue him. Avin, will you do me a favor? A favor? I have a bad feeling about this. Please take me with you! I want to help rescue Myle, too! I knew this was coming. I understand, but it's too reckless. Who cares? I'll do anything for Myle. Because we are destined to be together. Rutee says, Shannon, you should remain here. When Myle returns, he will need someone to warmly welcome him. I can't think of anyone else but you to be able to do that. I don't think Myle has been given enough food since he was captured, Rutee says. I'm sure he must be very hungry. Oh, poor Myle. If I'm hungry, I don't even have any energy to move. Right. Anyway, Shannon, it's better that you wait for Myle here. I think Myle would be more pleased that way. Avin says, yeah, he must fall in love with you again. Fall in love with me again, Myle. Hee hee. Come on, Avin. What do you want from me by buttering me up? Hello? Says Avin. Avin! I will be ready to welcome Myle. Please get Myle back for me. Says Avin. Haha, Michelle says she's a pretty merry person. Gawain says, yeah, she's charming in a strange way. She's relieved the tension before the battle. Maybe she intended to do that. Avin says, no, I think she's just a natural. Well, that's okay. I don't want to make Shannon sad anymore. I will save him this time for sure. Okay, guys. Gotta look around the entire town again. That'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.